Hi, my name is Yufei Yong. Today I'm going to introduce the causal map procedure for causal mediation analysis. In a causal mediation analysis, there are three main types of variables: a treatment variable, an outcome variable, and a mediator variable. The treatment variable is considered to be the root cause of the outcome, and part of its causal effect is mediated through the mediator variable. Here are some examples. A particular gene causally affects the chance of getting lung cancer, and some of its effect is mediated through its effect on increasing cigarette smoking. Or your daily stress leads to a sleep disorder, and it is mediated through its induction of emotional discomfort. Or a youth program reduces delinquent behavior in teenagers through its enhancement of teenagers' moral and social values. Common to all these examples, a hypothesized mechanism or mediation process is represented by the mediator variable. The treatment effect through the mediation process is called the mediated or indirect effect. In the last example, the enhancement of moral and social values of teenagers describes a mediation process. Notice that a direct arrow from program to delinquency remains here. This represents the direct effect of the treatment on the outcome. But more accurately, this is the part of the treatment effect that is not due to the specified mediation process. Finally, the total treatment effect includes both the mediated effect and the direct effect. In a causal mediation analysis, you study the causal mechanisms, and the mediation process serves as an explanation of the treatment effect. Specifically, you want to ask three main questions. How much of a mediation effect there is? How important the mediation process is? And what the treatment effect would be if you could somehow intervene in the mediation process. In practical research, especially in observational studies, you cannot randomly assign subjects to different treatment conditions. For example, teenagers participate in the youth program by their own choice. Even if you can randomly assign subjects to treatment conditions, random assignment to mediator conditions is usually not plausible. Because of the lack of random assignments, some background pretreatment characteristics of the subjects might have confounded the observed effects. These background pretreatment characteristics are also called confounding covariates because they induce extraneous associations among the treatment, mediator, and outcome variables by acting as common causes, as represented by the red arrows in the causal diagram. Therefore, causal mediation analysis must also deal with these confounding associations in order to get unbiased estimation of the causal treatment and mediation effects. Procausal MAT, which was first available in SESTAT 14.3, is designed to estimate causal mediation effects in observational studies. Theoretically, it is based on the counterfactual framework, which defines causal mediation effects by counterfactual outcomes. Under the counterfactual outcome framework and some statistical assumptions, procausal MAT uses regression adjustment methods to deal with confounding covariates so that you can get unbiased estimation of causal mediation effects. Let me now demonstrate how you can use the causal MAT procedure to estimate direct and indirect causal effects. In the youth program example, teenagers enter the youth program voluntarily. After 1 year, their moral and social values were measured by a psychological scale. Their delinquent behavior within 2 years after the program began was recorded. In addition to main variables in the causal mediation analysis, several individual characteristics that might serve as confounding covariates were also measured. These include initial delinquency of the subjects, their gender, their grade point average for measuring academic performance, whether they were introverted or extroverted, their socioeconomic status, either high, medium, or low, their family support on a four-point scale, and their initial moral and social values. These are all important confounding covariates that need to be controlled for in the causal mediation analysis. Let me explain the causal mesh setup step by step here. First, in the poor causal mesh statement, I input a simulated dataset youth with 800 observations. In the covariate statement, you list all the potential confounding covariate effects. In the model statement, you specify that the outcome variable, delinquency, is regressed on the treatment variable, program, and the mediator variable, value. The interaction effect is also included. Notice that the actual modeling of the outcome will also include those covariate effects that are specified in the covariate statement. In the mediator statement, you specify that the mediator value is regressed on the treatment variable, program. Again, the actual modeling of the mediator will also include those covariate effects that are specified in the covariate statement. In the class statement, you tell the procedure which variables are categorical or class variables. Variables that are not specified in the class statement are treated as continuous variables. You also use the descending option for the program variable here because you want to use reverse alphabetical order to indicate that a yes value represents the treatment condition. As you can see from the first set of the output, the program variable uses reverse alphabetical order for the levels. Proc causal mesh assumes that the first ordered level, here with the yes value, represent the treatment condition. In the model information table, because both the outcome and mediator variables are continuous, identity links are used. This means that linear regression models are used for both the outcome and mediator variables here. In the treatment profile table, you can see that there were 243 subjects in the treatment conditions and 557 subjects in the control condition. This is the main table of the mediation analysis results. The total causal treatment effect is minus 0.56, which is statistically significant. On average, there is a reduction of 0.56 in delinquent behavior after controlling for all confounding effects. The natural indirect effect shows that minus 0.11 of the total effect is due to the mediation of the moral and social values of the teenagers. The remaining effect of minus 0.45 is the natural direct effect. Because the natural direct effect and natural indirect effect add up to the total effect, dividing the indirect effect by the total effect and then multiplying by 100% will give you the percentage due to mediation. This percentage is 20% here. So 20% of the total program effect on reducing delinquent behavior is due to the enhancement of moral and social values. Today, I have demonstrated some main features of the causal mesh procedure. You can do much more with this procedure. Let me summarize the features here. First, the procedure can do maximum likelihood estimation of various causal mediation and related effects and their percentages by regression adjustment methods. You can use either bootstrap or asymptotic formulas to estimate standard errors and confidence intervals. The procedure also supports various data types, including continuous and binary outcome, treatment, and mediator variables, and continuous and categorical covariates. A limited set of generalized linear models is supported to fit the outcome and mediator models. The procedures provide several two, three, and four-way decompositions of total effects. It also provides very flexible evaluation of control direct effects and conditional mediation effects. Finally, it supports analysis that use the case control design. For more numerical demonstrations, please see my SAS Global Forum paper. For more information and additional resources, please visit our support page. Thank you.